Are you ready to jump right into QuickBooks Online and start using it? Well, in this episode of QuickBooks Online Crash Course, we're going to finish the remaining simple steps of the setup, preparing your reports and names list. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. There are very few remaining setup steps for this course. We just have to put aside four specific reports. Because if you're doing abbreviated minimum QuickBooks, those four reports are all you need. There are two sets of names that you have to put in the lists in QuickBooks Online, customers and vendors. And that's as easy as typing up a list in any software where you're just putting in simple data. So what are the four specific reports that you need? Well, you need the trial balance, which is the summary results of all accounts in the chart of accounts. You need to see the profit and loss, which will show the total of all the income accounts, the total of all the expense accounts, and the final net income. You also need to put up transaction list by customer and transaction list by vendor. And those names are self-explanatory. So for these four specific reports, before we put them in a place that makes it easy to find, each report must be set to show the results of all transactions regardless of date. Each report must be saved from the Common Reports section into the Custom Reports section. So again, these are the four reports we need. Very simple. In the left panel, you click Reports. Now, if you click Custom Reports, there are none of them now. This is the place we're going to put aside the specific reports that we need. So we click Standard, and first we'll scroll down to the Trial Balance. All the way at the end of the section that says For My Accountant, right at the bottom, Trial Balance, click on it. Now it shows you the trial balance. But what you need to do before you save it is click the pull-down date option and choose All Dates, and then click Run Report. And now you can see it doesn't say any specific date, it says All Dates. Now that it looks the way we need it to look, we click Save Customization. And of course, if we wanted to put a special name on it, we could. But let's just click Save. Now, why does that help us? It helps us because we can click Reports, now click Custom Reports, and just the ones we put aside are here. So here it is, Trial Balance. Let's go back to the Standard section. And go down to profit and loss. Profit and loss, just regular profit and loss. Profit and loss, just this one. Just the one that says profit and loss. You see this? Click on it. And again, we have to click the pull down date option, click all dates, run report. Now it's showing the result of all dates. Now, after we click Save Customization, of course, we won't change the name, but you could if you want to. Click Save. Now, when we click Reports and Custom Reports, you see that both of these are set aside in a place that we can get to them very quickly, and they look the way we need them to look. Let's quickly do the other two reports. Standard, go down here. And you'll get to sales and customers. You can just get transaction list by customer. Click on it. Remember, the pull-down makes it all dates, run report, save customization, and save. Let's do that for the vendors. Reports, standard, go down to your expenses and vendor section, transaction list by vendor, all dates, run report, save customization, and save. Now, when we click reports, custom, we have right at our fingertips each of the four reports that will give us all the information we need in a second. Now, the last part of the setup is the most simple. We're simply going to put in the names of the customers who pay us for service and the vendors whom we pay for the services we need to run the business. These are the names of the three example customers we will use, and these are the names of the four example vendors we will use. Or five, sorry. But please note, in this crash course, we will not spend time on additional name data, such as address, telephone number, email address, website, and so on. It will be very clear to you how to reopen any name to add this data anytime you need. So let's just take a look and read it off. The way to enter the customers in your customer list is to scroll to the section where it says customers. Click right here in the left panel. Okay, if it's your very first time coming here, you have to click Add Customers manually. Now, you have to put something in company, because company is the most important field. Of course, in a real situation, you would fill out all the rest of the data, and then, of course, you could reopen and change it. But we will just click Save. And you can see you now have one customer on your list, Alan Arby. Click Customers again, and it appears as a list. Then you can go to the top right, click New Customer, and again, the company name field is the most important one. Save. Now you have Betty on the list. Click Customer. Now, you see the two customers here, new customer, company name, save. Of course, if you go back to the customer list and you wish to add a phone number or change an email address, it's very simple. Click on the customer name and then click, once that customer is in front of you, simply click Edit, and you go back to the same customer information you opened before, and you can put in any of these fields.